We're very fortunate to have Johnny Valentine, the former U.S. Heavyweight Champion, with us today to add his comments to this match between Buddy Colt and Ron Fuller for the Florida and the Southern Heavyweight Championship at stake. Buddy Colt, the Florida Heavyweight Champion, Ron Fuller, the Southern Heavyweight Champion. And, John, this is your first opportunity to see this man in action in some time.
Yes, I saw Ron Fuller about a year ago, and he has really improved. He's a real seasoned professional now, and as this match progresses, I'm sure the fans will see that the man is not a shy boy anymore. He's really coming to his own, and he's finally a real professional because he really does his job out there, and he does it in a real seasoned way.
Noticed a moment ago that Fuller, of course, took advantage of his height to jump over a possible body block by Buddy Colt. Colt now momentarily had the upper hand, but a good looping left hand caught Colt in the midsection. Now a looping right hand caught him in the side of the jaw. Another one that has Colt on the canvas. This Buddy Colt is taking a lot of punishment, John.
Well, Buddy Colt is a tough man himself, and he's been around a long time and knows all the tricks. But Ron Fuller isn't given an inch of ground. He's staying right in there, and this is another thing where youth has a disadvantage sometimes. You kind of stand back and you're not aggressive enough when you've got an old seasoned veteran out there with you. You're a little shy or scared or something. I don't know what it is, but evidently Ron is not either of these things anymore.
Colt down on the canvas once again, and of course, as we said, both championships on the line. Buddy Colt, the Florida champion, Ron Fuller, the Southern champion. The winner of this match, of course, would gain both titles. Colt taking a lot of punishment, but keeps firing back a thumb to the throat of Ron Fuller, has Fuller on the canvas. Now they're outside the ring, and it's Buddy Colt picking up Ron Fuller outside the ring. And now watch now, Fuller taking some punishment here. But Fuller getting set now, trying to ram Buddy Colt's head into the turnbuckle, but instead his neck is run into the ring post, and he has been injured. There's no question about this. Buddy Colt putting a neck breaker on him outside the ring.
That hurt.
That's one thing about Buddy Colt, John. He takes advantage of every opportunity available.
Ron is still moving. That shows that he's got a lot of heart, because most people would have stayed right out there and been counted out.
Fuller hanging on now for dear life as Colt continues to issue punishment, but
that's about the smartest thing he could do, just hang on to something and protect himself, because obviously he's not in too good a shape.
Again, a forearm smash to the back of Ron Fuller. Ron Fuller still holding on, keeping in as close as he can, keeping those punches to where they don't have their full effectiveness. And again, another neckbreaker administered by Buddy Colt. And this would be enough to stop any average wrestler, wouldn't it, John?
Well, he may be stopped. This is what makes the difference. You can get up after being hurt, and obviously he did then. It means that you've really got the heart to go on and become champion. And he's still moving. He's not dead yet. He's still dangerous.
Buddy Colt now, sensing that he may have victory within his grasp, moving very methodically on Ron Fuller. Colt down with that big elbow across the throat of Ron Fuller. Now Colt getting up on the second rope. I might point out that's the second rope. The third rope would be illegal, the second rope, but Ron Fuller rolled away just in time.
It shows that Ron is, as hurt as he is, he's still thinking. And he took advantage of that one move there. It looks like it's evening up a bit now.
Ron Fuller now in this match is reduced to a barroom brawl between these two men.
There is the difference. There is the difference between this boy a year ago and today. A year ago, he'd have succumbed to all that punishment, but look at him now. He's really in there. He's fighting mad, and he's as hurt as he is and beat up. He's in there. He doesn't know anyone's there except Colt, and he's just trying to pound his head into the mat.
Now, this is, of course, part of the fabulous Fuller fighting heart. I'm sure he inherited some of this from his dad, Buddy Fuller. Here comes Chris Markoff now, a close friend of Buddy Colt. The referee is outside the ring.
Fuller doesn't know anybody's in there but Colt. He's only got a hold of him.
This is obvious. Markoff straining now, trying to pull Fuller away and unable to do so. Finally, upending Fuller, but only momentarily, as Fuller still gets back to that advantage position. And Markoff continues to try and pull him away. And this man has got literally a death grip on him.
Markoff can't even budge him.
Markoff still struggling, still trying to get Ron Fuller off of Buddy Colt. And now the great Malenko moves into the ring. And obviously, with the referee outside the ring, the great Malenko took it upon himself to try and even the score here just a little bit. Even the odds.
Ron has still got him. He's really got him now. I think Colt's, he's had it. Look at the Colt.
And the referee calling for the bell, I believe. I noticed him signaling as he entered the ring. He's calling for the bell. And Malenko, you're right. He doesn't...
I think Malenko's even trying to pull him off. Well, Malenko doesn't want the kid getting in trouble now, I guess.
And it's obvious Fuller does not realize there's anybody in the ring except his objective, his quarry, and that quarry, of course, is Buddy Colt.
He's not fighting with anything but instinct now. He just, all he sees a body, he wants a pound on it. Look at him go.
Three more men in the ring trying to contain
him. How many are holding him? Five, six? They can't hold him. Look at him go. He still wants it. Look at the head of Colt there.
Buddy Colt leaving the ring, and he doesn't want any more of this whatsoever, but Ron Fuller is still after him. Crawling after him now, trying to get him in any manner that he can.
He's got him again. Look at that bloody head of Colt. It shows you with a killer instinct that Ron Fuller had. Everyone thinks that he was just an innocent little kid, but that shows that there he goes again. That shows he has a killer instinct. That's what you need to be great.